that's a wrap. On to the food.
I'm Erin, aka Pack Mule. Today, focus on my stuff. Fit_free_love_life on Instagram. Follow me. Amazing. And Erin Hodges Fitness on YouTube.
Yes.
So we're going to go get brunch at Tom's now. I've been there like a billion times. This is my place that I bring people. So stay tuned for pancakes.
They now have cinnamon roll pizza.
Is amazing. If you guys haven't tried Legendary Foods, highly recommend it. Blueberry, cinnamon bun, cashew butter. Do it. I'll put the link in the description. Don't have a coupon code, but I am an ambassador for them. We just don't do coupon codes. They always have free shipping on their orders, so it's all totally fine.
It's affordable. So I didn't want to interrupt her, but she got me cashew butter and almonds. Vlogception.
For the gram. We don't actually eat this, guys.
We just take pictures of it.
Just take pictures.
I'm gonna eat this so much right now. Got the goods.
Also just put a couple of scoops of the PE Science aminos into my gallon because it's 3 o'clock and I haven't drank any water. We're drinking. I'm a trainer, I'm not in college anymore.
All right guys, so let's talk about what just happened. I just had a free meal. Hey. I get one of those a week prescribed to me by my coach, Nick Tong, but I want to break it down for you guys and be honest. I believe, in my opinion, as a coach, as a trainer, as a knowledgeable person in the fitness industry, as a human being, I believe that it is extremely important to enjoy your life. And a lot of enjoyable things come through food. We go out, I just went out with a friend and had brunch. That's an enjoyable experience. Yeah, we don't have to center it around the food, but yeah, the food was great. It was fantastic, and it was great to catch up with an old friend. Now, the thing here is that too many people deprive themselves. Too many people who don't need to. If you're on prep, hell yeah, you probably need to deprive yourself a little bit. That's just part of it. That's just what, and you're doing prep. You're not forced to do prep. You decided to do it. So if you have to take your meals out to dinner if you're on prep, it's okay, be that person. But why would you want to be that person if you're not on prep or if you don't have a deadline like that? If you're just living your life, because health and fitness, it shouldn't be just miserable like a lot of people make it. It should be an enjoyable experience. It should be an enjoyable lifestyle. Being healthy, being happy, that's what this is all about. A lot of people will just lose out on a lot of opportunities because of how strict they are. Go out and enjoy yourself once in a while. I don't mean go out every single day and have a burger, have pizza, have pancakes. Go out once a week, have what you want, and just enjoy it. Enjoy the food, enjoy the people, enjoy the environment. Because if you're not enjoying life, then are you really living? I spent way too much time in my life wasting it. Because I was in this eating disorder that basically destroyed my life. I can't even remember what I was like before I had it. I would love to feel like that again, to just be able to do what I want when I want. I love this lifestyle, I love health, I love fitness, I love it. It is my life, it is what I have, and it is my career. It's just, it's a lifestyle. If you deprive yourself, it can't be a lifestyle because you can't do that long term. Eventually, your body's gonna give out. I was killing myself. I was doing Let me admit to you guys what I was doing. I've admitted it to a lot of people. But I don't think I've ever admitted it on YouTube. And saying it is kind of frightening. I got to the point back when in April, before I started with Nick, when I relapsed. And it took me a while to realize it. A bunch of people were telling me, hey, Kaitlyn, you're losing a lot of weight. You're looking sick. And I ignored it because when I looked in the mirror, I just saw something else. Listen to the people around you, step one. Listen to the people around you. They care about you, they love you. They're not trying to hurt your feelings. They're trying to tell you straight. They're worried about you. I had people my cousins, who would rarely express concern, telling me that something's wrong. And that's kind of when it hit me. Something's really wrong. I could barely get out of bed. That's not good. I was walking through the streets and I just wanted to drop dead. That's not normal. My heart would flip. Sometimes it would just like skip a beat. Sometimes I would go to bed with a pain in my chest and I thought I was gonna die. Now, I was to the point where I was doing about 2 hours of high intensity cardio a day on top of about an hour and a half of high intensity weight training. I would wake up 5 a.m, no matter what. Doesn't matter if I went to bed at 2 a.m. Doesn't matter when I got home last night. Doesn't matter. That was what I was doing. Rest wasn't important to me. Go, 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 go. That's what I was thinking. If I was sitting still for too long, I was bad. I wasn't burning calories. I wasn't doing anything. I wasn't being efficient. So I would get to the gym, hop on that treadmill, hit up some intervals. Lowest speed I would go was 8, highest speed I would go was 12, incline always increasing for about 30 minutes. I would usually do about 4 miles, sometimes more. Then I'd do some sprints because why not, right? After my sprints, I would then go over and do some extremely stupid supersets. High volume, no rest, crazy stuff, heavy weights, just barely being able to get through this. I would literally cry sometimes during workouts because I just wanted it to stop. I wasn't enjoying it anymore. I used to love to train, and I lost that. And now I have it back. Oh, but I'm not done yet. After all the weights, I would hop on that Stairmaster because why not, right? Burn more calories, Kaitlyn. Put it up to the highest level of 20, hang on for dear life, and do about 20 to 30 minutes, sometimes even 40 minutes. But then I would do intervals with the battle ropes and with slam balls because I don't know. I couldn't stop. I was to that point where I couldn't stop. I knew what I was doing was wrong, but I didn't know how to stop. One day I go onto Instagram, I was looking through people's Instagrams, I looked on Emily Duncan's, I was like, wow, she looks really good for her show. Ooh, who's her coach? Let me check him out. Nick Tong, now accepting clients. Let me email him and see what the prices are, because I'm in this hole and I can't get out and I need help. And I don't know where else to go. I don't want to die. But slowly I was becoming okay with the fact that I knew I was dying. I kind of wanted to die at some points. And that's when I knew it was just not a good situation. Nick got back to me right away. He told me the price and I said, wow, I can do that. I can afford that. Yeah, it'll be tight, but this is necessary at this point. So now Nick's my coach. He's been my coach for, I don't know, like 4 months, 5 months. I don't know. I'm bad with time. But my mind has completely changed since then. I train now for efficiency, not just to burn calories. I don't do cardio. I've gained weight, yeah, but I feel a hell of a lot better. And I look a hell of a lot better. I don't look like I'm dying. I don't feel like I'm dying. And it wasn't until yesterday until I realized I had my heart skipped a beat yesterday for whatever reason randomly. And I was like, wow, I haven't felt that in a while. And then I was like, wow, I used to feel that all the time. Or wow, I had a headache the other day. Wow, I feel like I can't really walk. Oh wow, this is how I used to feel all the time. So now that this rant is going on about 5 or 6 minutes probably at this point, I just want to end it here. If you feel like you have an eating disorder, if you need help, reach out to somebody. Help I'm not an expert, but reach out to me. I can help you as much as I can. I hate to see people go from one end of the spectrum to the other. I hate to see people turn a lifestyle of health and fitness into an eating disorder. Because an eating disorder is an extremely serious thing. Word to the wise, guys. Please, get help. I know it's probably going to be the most difficult decision you'll ever have to make because you want to do everything on your own and you don't feel like you have a problem. But life shouldn't be that hard. And I'm starting to learn that. Life was way too hard. It shouldn't be like that. Enjoy your life. Please. Done. Alright, so it's 5:41. I kind of tried to take a nap, but I kind of just ended up laying in my bed just struggling to sleep, which is annoying because it's Sunday, I want to chill, but whatever. Now I have to go out and get some groceries for dinner tonight and a couple things for meal prep, so I'm going to take a walk right now. And the temperature dropped pretty drastically, and it's really windy in Rockaway because I live by the beach. So I'm going to resort to sloth mode right now. Scarf, pea coat, hoodie, ape athletic joggers, and these Nike Connects. So the cat is legit just watching my tripod. Yeah, camera shy. Now he's looking again, but I'll show you what I get when I come back. All right, so I didn't get anything special, like I said. Just got some oats, peppermint tea, jasmine rice, Boar's Head spicy brown mustard, aka my favorite condiment, some dairy-free vegan chocolate chips. I put that in my oatmeal for post-workout. What else? And then I just got some shredded lettuce and cherry tomatoes and frozen fruit, which I already put away. I also had to pick up some more of these because they're my favorite Oreo, and I love to have them on my free meal days. So I'm going to have a couple of those later, but you'll see that. So I'm going to do the dishes, meal prep, and next meal. Alright, so this is take two because my mom didn't press record, so I've already tried the nut butter, but I'm going to try it again and pretend I haven't. It's so good. Honestly, I give this a 10 out of 10. It's so perfect. Thank you, Erin. I love you. Now my actual dinner is just a giant salad because I crave salads when I have free meals because I have so many carbs and I crave I crave protein, you know. So I got some tomatoes, some yellow tomatoes because aesthetics, some cucumbers, spinach, iceberg lettuce, and chicken, and I use Tabasco sauce as dressing, the Chipotle one, because it's the best hot sauce. Fact. Progress on water, not that bad. So, I'm gonna eat this, and I'll probably finish this video with a food montage, because that's just what I seem to be doing lately. You fight me off like a firefighter. So tell me why you still get burned. You say you're not, but you're still a liar. Cause I'm the one that you run to first. Every time, yeah, why do you try to deny it when you show up every night and tell me that you want me, but it's complicated, so complicated. When